my thing while you are doing your thing in a minute. I'm sure you'll be helpful in answering any questions that you might have. And possibly they might even ask for a photo shoot afterwards.
Yeah.
I've already done one this morning. All right. Now, DMAC tells you what I want to cover. However, before I do that, you guys can do that in your own time at home. Before I do that, I actually want to do the prep for the exam. I want you guys to be completely informed about what to expect, what the purpose is, and what you can plan and prepare for. I think what happens is we say, exams next week, go and study. Make sure you're studying. Are you studying? Your parents go, you've got exams next week. Are you studying? And nobody's going to have to go, well, what the hell study? What do I do? So I'm going to give you some hints and tips as well as topics. If you think all I'm going to do is say it once and you're suddenly an expert, you might want to think through that again. It takes repeated visits, repeated reminders, and opportunities to go, hey, that works for me, or no, it doesn't. Okay, so quick revision on what would likely be on this exam. What was our first topic right at the beginning of the semester? Topic one, what was it? Climatic disasters was your topic heading, okay? Now, in this particular topic, I'm going to color code stuff today, so that will hopefully help you. In this particular topic, we actually did two assessments. The first one was a really, really easy warm-up activity. It was just about the facts of things. So 1A was basically what we know. It was just really simple. Here's the facts, this is what we know. Chris, I highly recommend you take down these notes. These are your pointers, your guidelines for what you will think about when you're sitting at home the night before your exam. The second assignment was a little more in depth, and you had to do an understanding of, you had to compare how different societies respond to a natural disaster. Now, we could have looked at this. We could have used any of our natural disasters for our comparison and analysis. We could have used cyclones, we could have used droughts or bushfires, but we used in this instance floods. I would highly recommend that you don't reinvent the wheel and go and try and learn a whole new piece of information about how two different societies dealt with a cyclone destruction. Stick with what you know. We talked about Mozambique and Brisbane, or Bangladesh and Brisbane. If you wish to compare Mozambique and Bangladesh, just know that you are comparing societies that are quite similar in lots of respects. So there's not really the comparison. If anything, you might analyze and say they're similar. You're looking at two similar responses and consequences and recovery processes because of a range of elements, like their lower socioeconomic developed country status, like their population, what's the word? careful that you're not comparing apples and apples. Think about trying to compare two different sets of community in terms of economics, politics, environment, social, cultural aspects. Okay, what was our second topic? Once we'd finished with natural disasters, what was our next main topic? What
is the problem? Why? That one's looking at some of the causes and the influences around choices. And finally, suggest possible solutions. Now, this is not an aspect that you may have necessarily presented in your assignment. I want you to actually, I'm going to put big asterisks and circles around this, suggest possible solutions. Whoa, spelling. Okay, so they're the key things you need to put. So when it looks at that, and says, great, and says, yes, you said I had to go and revise my assignment that I did on pollution, but what am I revising? What do I have to know? What am I going to have to write about? What am I going to have to do? There are some tips. And our third topic that we have done this semester and are still doing that you need to prepare for is how? What's our third one?
Comparative societies.
Comparative societies, yeah. Now, in terms of your comparative societies, again, you are all choosing slightly different areas. There are some similarities, again, that you need to be looking at so that you will have enough to discuss. And they run pretty much the same as this. Who? How and what skills do you need to bring to this assignment? Part two, I just want to work out. So, your exam is, this is all about your exam preparation. Do you not need this assistance, Ryan?
No.
one double lesson is actually technically 90 minutes. Plus 10 read. You guys know that, don't you?
Yeah.
You've done enough of these now. You're in year 10. These are some of your last ones. Been there, done that. You get that, yeah? Until you sit here in the lesson and I see all these panic faces and like freaked outness. You should be approaching these really calmly by now. You should go, yeah, been there, done that. Got the t-shirt. Know how this is going to go. So when you do come in, I expect to hear lots of moaning and groaning and grumbling. But at the end of the day, remind yourself, you know what you're doing. You do these well. These are not scary. I don't design them to somehow trick you. I mean, short of actually showing you the paper today, there's not much else I can really remind you of. You've got one double lesson. Your assessment criteria. Who knows what the assessment criteria for this exam is?
A, B, C, D.
Who knows where they can find it out even if I don't tell them right now? Where on day map?
Your outline.
Well done. So, Willie, what is it?
ACD, probably.
No. Oh, did I put this on your assessment task? Oh, you guys are lucky then. I thought I was going to put this on your assessment task. I might just put it on your assessment task because I think it's a valuable thing. A and D. All right, my apologies. Okay, now, I know that you guys do lots of IB subjects and they're slightly different, so let's just remind ourselves. Criteria A is your knowledge and understanding. And criteria D, is, who knows what criteria D is for humanities? Critical thinking, thanks. From an IB school from her own country, so she knows it. How come you lot don't? Critical thinking. You could be safe next year, but until then, you're still IB. Critical thinking. Now, yeah, I know. Far out. Let's have a look at that then. Let's have a look at this. Where's your critical thinking? Where's your knowledge and understanding going to be assessed? This one here is all criteria A. This is criteria A. This is criteria A. All you have to do is memorize a bunch of facts. Revise what you learned in when you did the assignment. Go back and revisit the facts. But the critical thinking fits in here. This requires for you to make a suggestion and give opinions and evaluations. So that is criteria D. This bit here, where you suggest possible solutions, where you give me all the facts and you put them together to make, formulate your own suggested solution, backed by facts, critical thinking. There. And this one here. Be careful when you're writing this exam not to sit at the low level thinking stuff of, hey, here's a bunch of facts I know, aren't I good? You need to step into the next step of giving opinions and evaluations, suggesting possible solutions for the benefits to society. You will respond, or you will demonstrate your knowledge with extended written responses. There is no true or false. There is no multiple choice. There's not even short answer questions, you know, one or two sentences. Every question will be like little mini essays. Okay? Have you written any of this down? I actually have. I'm not putting this on day mat. It is too important for you need to actually write it from here into your book. Okay, but
ya harusnya ini loh tadinya mau disebut dulu kan ini terlalu banyak tugas-tugas siswa juga
masih sudah berapa nanti. Did you write it better on the board the first time, the second time? I don't really know. I'm making that up as I go along.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I'm doing good.
I'll be fine. I've already chosen something that I'm going to do for the international aid.
Yeah. I'm just, you know, in terms of preparation,
yeah.
If you go through your lessons, have a look at your lessons tab, day map, when is the exam? Double lesson next week.
Yeah, but what day?
Wednesday, our double lesson. Look at your timetable. Right, there you go.
22nd.
Oh, wait, no.
No, I was wrong. Sorry.
I know the 22nd Sunday, a different day.
Can I see your timetable?
Yeah, sure.
So
I'll just change it to the current,
right week.
Yeah, the current day.